Here's a common layout issue on the web, and the spacing is ridiculous. Three cards, three div blocks, right next to each other. And since they all have the same class applied, I can add some margin to this. Nice. Here's the problem. Whenever I use margin like this, it invariably creates extra space on the sides. So what do? I get out my ruler, my scissors, and my Opolar electric air blower. But after that, I would create two combo classes. One to remove the right margin from the right card, and a second to remove the left margin from the left card. Yada, yada, yada. Not the simplest form of web development. What about grid? Grid is great for two-dimensional layouts like this. In other words, we can add a gap between the columns, or even between rows. However, when we have an interface like this, where stuff is wrapping to the next line, there are lots of ways to build it. Right here, I'm using CSS grid, and when the three items on top aren't lined up with the two items below, we have to use linear algebra to calculate the column design to support this. Not ideal. Enter flexbox. It's what's for dinner. It's also how I can create layouts like this, but align and justify them by controlling the styles on the parent element. Click, click. This mouse isn't even connected. But notice how these zoom things are overflowing. That's okay, because Flexbox also lets me turn on wrapping. Once we've done that, we can align the rows how we want. And with this parent element selected, I can take all the power of grid gap from CSS grid and access it in my flex controls. I can add a gap between columns, and I can add a gap between rows. No more having to undo margin math manually, no more grids that require vector calculus to develop, all because of flex gap in the Webflow Designer.